to another edition of the Empower Hour. I am Al-Kumar.
And I'm Hanifa.
And we are here on this fourth day of July to talk with you guys about independence.
Yeah.
What does independence really look and feel like?
A different kind of independence.
And I am so excited to introduce these ladies here. This is Nick and Six. And they are the duo, Nick and Six,
yes.
Right?
Yes, the band.
Okay, okay. And we met these young ladies not long ago.
A couple weeks ago.
And I was just so excited to talk to you guys. And then then when you agreed to come on the program and share with others, I was like, oh, because we've been Hanifa for a while.
Yeah.
Have been wanting to do a program like this.
From earlier this year, or even possibly last year. We had it on the list.
Yes, we did. And here you guys are. Yeah. So it was like awesome. a blessing walking through the door.
Yeah.
So Nick and Six, tell the audience who you are and what do you guys do?
Okay, well, I am Kayla.
And I'm Six, or Denise Reese.
And we are Nick and Six of the Purple Days Movement.
Yes.
So, really what we do is we are professional human beings. We live for a living.
Okay.
We are purple people, which means we are people
understanding responsibilities for people's lives everywhere.
Okay.
And that's how the band Nick and Six formed, because Denise's movement, honestly, she's the founder. Purple Days Movement is about using your tools, your skills,
your gifts to make a difference in your family, community, and world.
Okay.
And so we actually met as roommates, but at the time our skills, tools, and gifts were needed.
Yeah.
And so we came together and started learning some music together, and the band sort of formed from there. We both play multiple instruments, so we're like, hey, let's try this, let's try that. Like, so.
And that's just one facet.
Right.
The phenomenal with what is your lives.
Yeah.
Because I am just so interested and mesmerized by your lifestyle.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So can you share with, so what do you guys do? You have a van.
Yes. We are Tiny Livers.
We are mobile tiny livers.
What does that mean?
Yes. Well, let's start with the purple bus. So Denise took a 1982 Bluebird school bus and converted it into a motorhome recording studio and live performance venue. So that is actually how we started the Tiny Living thing together, because when we came together as roommates in Arizona, we were actually playing on the streets to pay somebody else's bills. And then she tells me she has a home that she owns sitting in Mississippi because it broke down as she was headed across the country.
A mobile home?
Yeah.
Okay.
The Bluebird school bus, the purple bus.
Oh, I see.
Yeah.
I see.
So I'm like, why are we playing to pay somebody's rent when you own a home? Like, hello, we need to
get
up out of here. So we went to save the purple bus. It hasn't been up and running since. Actually, it was for a little bit. It ran for 133 miles
outside of Mississippi to Louisiana.
And so after trying to save the purple bus and just trying to get that accomplished in the South, we finally came to the East Coast, which is where we purchased our Class C RV motorhome.
Okay.
So now we're doing the Tiny Living on a Class C RV, which is like kind of like the old people mobile that you'll see, like people riding in the retirees.
Okay.
But we've like decked it out with our own.
Yeah, we painted the outside. Inside has been completely renovated.
Yeah.
It's like a nice little studio apartment.
Okay.
Wow. Yeah. So but we are responsible for, dumping our tanks.
Yeah. Charging our batteries. To
all of that.
Live off the grid, off, not plugging into shore power.
We're living completely off the grid.
Yeah. How long have you been living like this?
Since December of 2016.
Okay. It's been almost two years now.
Yeah.
What is like the greatest challenge for people who can see you guys like, yeah, I wouldn't mind living like that? What can you say to them has been your experience that they should know before they embark on a mission like that?
honestly the harassment that our viewers endure. Yeah, like I can't tell you how many times a day our door gets knocked on by like park rangers, police, security cars, parking enforcement, like people thinking they can tell us to move just because it's an RV. Yeah. Like people basically, like, I hate the whole cliche of people hate what they don't understand, but that genuinely has been our experience with RVs.
So what, you guys don't go the traditional route where people will go to RV homes?
We don't do RV camps. I mean, we could, but you're able to park in different parking lots or park on the street. Like, there's no...
It's like a car.
Yeah, because it is our car.
Right. Okay.
It's like when we run to Shoppers really quick or we run to the store up the street, like taking our RVs.
You know? But if you have to spend like the overnight there, don't you have to? Because I know like here after certain hours you can pull, right?
We don't park our business. No, it's never an overnight thing. We're never illegally parked when people come knocking on our door.
That's the whole thing.
We always
enter the business.
Yeah.
And then hang out in the parking lot for a little bit, but then we'll move on. We never sleep overnight where you're
in anybody's business.
It says no overnight parking. Yeah. Don't do that.
We're always legally parked, but people always find their income.
That's what I was saying.
Okay, so you guys, were you roommates in college or just roommates in general?
No, Denise is way past college age. I dropped out.
Well, there is no college age. People go all the time.
But I'm saying because people think you're like 20. I'm just saying, like, she's not. And I dropped out of college after my first semester because I just knew I was too smart for it. So,
what were you trying to study?
Way too smart for college. I was a communications major. I was on the dean's list, and I said, this is not for me.
Because that's what I was going to ask, if this is, this way of life, is it something that you guys always aspire to, or is it just something where you sat down and it was just common sense? Like,
I mean, coming up, my family used to take vacations in RV camps and do stuff like that, and it's just been my dream to travel across the country in an RV.
Yeah.
And then as time, you know, as I was coming up, I was in a band, I fell in love with music, and the way artists are treated, like you go to play at a venue, they don't have a backline of music or a proper sound system for bands to come play out of. So I'm like, okay, I'm done with all these half-ass venues not having good sound and treating artists properly. So I'm like, boom, how can I do mobile living and have a live space for musicians and kids, because not all places allow kids to come in. Boom, here's a mobile stage for kids to have a place, or any artist to have a space, and here I have the sound system, I have a keyboard, I have drums, I have a bass, I have guitars. Boom, let's just share and care.
Was this what Purple Days was?
This is how Purple Days came together.
And that was the Purple Bus.
Yeah.
Okay.
So, but my life has just helped me shape and form Purple Days, and then meeting her only a year and a half ago now.
Okay.
Yeah, we only just are meeting and forming this tight bond that we have as Nick and Six. But for her to already have had her amazing existence, I've had mine, and to join forces like this has just been awesome.
Yeah. And you mentioned children.
Yes.
So you guys do have children.
No, we don't. I have been performing professionally as an actress, singer, and dancer since 2 years old.
Oh.
So I have had the support system to be able to work professionally. I mean, from being on Broadway and going on international tours to actually do this for a living all my life. So that's really why I said I was too smart for college.
Okay.
I'm like, I've already been working professionally at my dream. Why do I need to come like play pretend adult for 4 years to get a piece of paper and be an adult? I mean, that's what college is. It literally does give these kids like kind of this delusional idea about what adulting is about when they're living on these campuses that a whole town is a campus, and they're
the college
like,
town,
and right? They're like riding go karts down to
grocery shop and blah blah.
That's why I said that about college. But to be able to work professionally in what I have been passionate about from a very young age, I know not everybody gets that opportunity, and so I've always wanted to be a part of. Being able to provide a space for young people to come and express themselves and really get a chance at working in their passion.
Yeah.
And so meeting Denise and learning about the Purple Bus, like I said, I'm like, why are we being so nice right now? Why are we not going and building this thing?
Yeah.
So,
because it has a shower, it has kitchen, it's fully livable.
Yeah. And so even though we were stranded in Mississippi, we're in purple days all the time.
Yeah,
purple
days every day. I wish the bus was right outside.
I know. I know.
I
know.
I'm so curious. You lose all track of time. You lose, like, you don't even realize you're on planet Earth anymore. You just zone out. You can go in the back and share and care, or you can just sit on the front benches and just hang out, just vibe out. It's just, I miss it. We gotta go visit.
So, Nick, you're 36, and Nick, you're how old?
I am ageless.
Okay,
no, I am literally ageless, because I have been, like I said, working professionally as an entertainer for 20 plus years now.
Okay.
So, like, I'm like Auntie Nick. So, like, you know what I mean? So, like, most of the people that I come across in my day-to-day life that are old enough to be my parents, but it's like, they're like, why do I feel like I'm talking to my mom?
I know.
Right now? I'm like, because I've been...
The reason why I asked is because I was going to ask the cell phone piece.
Yeah.
You know, you guys you guys don't have cell phones.
And, yes.
And as a form of communication. Can you let us know why you don't have cell phones?
Honestly, we were kind of forced. when we went from Phoenix to Mississippi, we, of course, were out of cell range, out of Wi-Fi range. So, like, we didn't have phones then. Mm-hmm. So...
And how long were you there?
We were in Mississippi for, what, two and a half months?
Oh, wow.
Together. So she was in Mississippi by herself with no phone for 4 months.
Okay.
Before we even met each other.
Okay.
So being there without being in cell range and stuff kind of like detached us from it.
Yeah.
And then once we actually got out of the South, we had like a stalker situation. Like literally somebody like... Yes, stalking and harassing us. It's funny now because we can look back on it and laugh, but it's not funny
at the time.
So
we got rid of them.
We had to get rid of our numbers, like everything, because it was.
Weren't doing social media as much.
Yeah, because I've noticed you guys got a pretty extensive following on Instagram.
Yeah.
So people follow you guys and watch.
Yeah, our combined total of following is like something of like maybe the 10,000. But we don't get on there. So
I'd rather meet and talk face-to-face. Even when people catch us at a pop-up, they're like, really, what video can you catch me? I'm like, you're catching us right now, right here,
this
right
is
now.
This
is the show, right here. Like.
And so did the stalker, did they come from the social media scene? Or they
actually tracked us both down via social media and was the reason that we actually met each other as roommates, which is the crazy part.
Yeah, we met through
The person whose bills we were paying.
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
So,
once
we, like, got out of the situation, they're like, well, hold up, we're going to pay my bills now.
Yeah.
Y'all need to come back.
So that's why they would stop. Okay.
But then once we went back to the West Coast, it actually became, like, an actual, like, physically stalking us. Wow. Like, we would be out in public. This person was, like, riding back and forth in their car, like,
switching positions
and stopping in the middle of the street.
Dude,
it was crazy.
See you. Like,
So you guys did away with the cell phones.
Yeah.
Okay. So tell us, how is life without cell phones in 2018?
It's awesome.
It's amazing.
I
never liked the way the cell phone stuff was going anyway. Like texting and stuff, I hate. Like, I'd rather just talk on the phone. If we're gonna communicate via phone, right? And she's even more old school than me. She's like, I don't even want to talk face to face.
I want to feel what your reaction is to whatever we're discussing.
I can't get that
from a text or from over the phone.
And I feel like I've had a lot less like communicative issues with
There's no way for people to like miss understanding, because we're having face-to-face conversations, and it's good if you can feel me if you have a problem, but I'm saying now you can say it because you're right here and not going to be able to come here. Our parents are missing at home, you know, we need to call our parents. So how has the support from family been as far as you guys' lifestyle?
It's touch and go.
Well, it depends on whose side of the family you're talking about. In terms of her side of the family, there's like a few people that are very supportive, and then there's other situations where it's touch and go. But I just feel like we have a great like little village. Like we have our own little chosen family between like close family friends and like people that we grew up with that think what we're doing is really dope. We have a really little village. We definitely have driveways to pull into.
Yeah.
Like,
But okay. Definitely, you know, the parents, my mom specifically was more concerned about me having a job with benefits and all that.
Her so mom is a baby boomer.
She's so concerned about me just saying bye, 9 to 5 work.
That's what I'm thinking about. Yeah. Yeah. Mothers are, need to, you know, we had a sister on the show not too long ago. She was doing, she was an entrepreneur. She was like 21. Mm-hmm. And she moved from Ohio, I think it was, and just came to D.C. Mm-hmm. And so one of the things that she was saying she struggles with is the age. People look at her because she's younger. Mm-hmm. And also family who means well, you know, you need to get a job.
Yeah.
You know, because they see her as security.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm. Because it's a false
It's an illusion. Yeah.
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 So I get the pleasure of not having to deal with that because, like I said, I've been working professionally in my fashion, like living my dreams since 2 years old.
And
so
I've tried.
Nobody even is bothering to.
Oh, you've tried?
I have my
own. Oh, she's a nurse.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
I've tried working in the healthcare field. I've tried working in schooling systems, but
was not working in the healthcare field
when we met.
And
they don't really care. If you don't have the proper paperwork, you're not getting the proper care. The school system is trying to force this traditional education system on people, and like people learn differently.
Yeah.
So I can't go with putting people in all these boxes. We're all on the planet together. Everybody's got skills and tools and gifts. So just be a purple person and understand your responsibility for people's lives everywhere.
Mm-hmm. And like, that's why we're literally just boots on the ground, getting that message out there. That's our job. Like
working the job just it frustrates me because I'm like, I'm here to serve these people and take care of them, but because we're understaffed, like 10 of my residents aren't going to get looked at right now because we're understaffed and I got to stay on this one. Stuff like that. I can't do that. I took an oath to help people, and you're making me violate that oath because you want to not have staff here because we want them.
You can sit by and watch it.
So did you gradually remove yourself from that?
My last gig was in Phoenix, Arizona, and my guy actually transitioned, and then it was perfect. I was just like, okay, like he's gone on.
No more patients.
Yeah. We had already just started building our street sidewalk rocks. I'm like, okay, I don't have to take another job.
And we played the Lauryn Hill show specifically. Oh, yeah. And Lauryn Hill told us that we are a band.
And it was
so
just like,
from that moment forward, and she's like, okay, well.
Yeah, I'm like, I'm done.
I'm done. I'm not talking in anymore.
Yeah. Like, Lauryn Hill has spoken. Lauryn Hill has spoken. That's it. Like, and I've been waiting to meet her forever.
Oh, yeah.
Like, now, meeting Nick, jamming with her, and now we meet Lauryn. I'm like, what the heck? This is just too many dreams just coming together. Wow. It's been my dream to live this way and not have to punch a clock and still be able to make a difference in people's lives and still be able to do my nursing. I still like to paint and build things.
Okay.
I do so many activities. I don't want one job. I want to just
help people.
Yeah.
So what's the biggest difference in your life versus where you were in the system versus where you are now? What do you look back at in life? You know, does it feel better?
Well, I feel like I'm not any more like out of the system than I was than I have been always, because like I said, I was working professionally as a performer. So like, even though I'm working in art, it's still a job. I still have to clock in. I still am a member of a union. You know what I mean? I still have a union to answer to, and I still belong to those unions. I still am auditioning for mainstream stuff, or stuff that's very much so systematic. I read for Netflix films. I read for, you know what I mean?
Okay. That's mainstream stuff. I've never been a part of that. So she gets it. I'm like,
oh yeah. So I don't really feel like I'm any more unplugged than I have always been, except for the now, like my actual living lifestyle part of it, actually tiny living. And I guess the major difference is just literally the space and being responsible for my own waste.
Yeah.
That changes the
eating habits drastically.
You ride around with your own waste. I'm telling you, you ain't gonna want it to smell.
Yeah, it smells like vegetable broth to me.
But you have to eat clean. You will suffer the consequences.
Right.
How about yourself?
Being unplugged now? It feels great. I don't have the headache and the burning in my stomach, like, or the aggravation of dealing with the rules and the jobs and the just I just feel so much free, and my life is much better. I'm not smoking the way I used to. I used to smoke clove cigars all the time. I used to drink coffee heavily. I used to not get enough rest. I didn't exercise, and I'm a certified aerobic instructor. So it's just like now I have time to live
and understand responsibility. Yeah, for your life, life as well, and not for only other just folks.
It's not like it's just. I hope people get to feel this one day. I don't care whatever it is. If you're a doctor, lawyer, like. The freedom that I have now, I'm going to get all emotional.
That's all right.
But the freedom I have now is just so beautiful. I just hope people get to experience it and unplug from this world. Because it's just, it's terrible. They have us setting up for failure all the time. But we all have the skills and abilities to help each other stop with all this stuff. If even it's just a hug for somebody or a safety pin. We were out the other day, I'm like, I bet you somebody had the safety pin on them right now, but because we don't talk to each other, we will never know what skills and tools and gifts people have to help each other. It's just, I hope everybody gets this free.
I was in New Jersey for graduation maybe a couple of weeks ago, and we walked, my friends and I were coming out of IHOP with the kids, the girls, and as we're coming out, there's a guy and a woman out there, and something is happening where they embrace each other and they're all like happy and laughing, and my friend and I walk into it, and my friend was not having a good morning, and so I was just like, oh, group hug, and she's just like, no. You know, and the lady, the lady that was embracing the guy, she was hesitant too. So I was like, come on, brother, let's bring it in. And he and I hugged for a little while, and we were laughing. And then once they see us, did that, my friend didn't have any choice because they wanted to squeeze her.
Yeah, you know.
And then it's so funny that after that we walked out, she's all smiling. You see, the weight is a little lifted. You know, and sometimes you just have to do those things.
And energy.
Yeah. And she looked at me and be like, she was like, only you. I'm like, sometimes you just have to just
go with the
Yeah. They were out there embracing it. You could feel that energy. I'm like, I want some of that right now.
Why not?
And they were strangers, but they were nice enough. The lady was hesitant, but we don't get enough of that in the world.
Right? Yeah, I literally was just—you were just reading my writing on this yesterday.
Yes,
it's literally a part of the book that I'm working on, but it's literally just the fact that we all just need to do what we feel like doing.
Yes.
Like you not screaming when you feel like screaming, you not crying when you feel like crying, and you not dancing when you feel like dancing is the reason that the world is not at peace.
If you getting up every morning doing something that you
don't want to do,
do
you know what kind of energy you're putting into the universe
every day,
forcing yourself to do things that you don't want to do?
But you know who we can learn from? Kids.
Yes.
When you say that, I think of my son, and you know, they, of course, as adults, we're like, don't do that, don't do it, don't do that. And they enough knows. After a while, they become like us, right? And so, but kids, they do what they want. You know, you put music on, my son, he's in the store, and he's the only person in there dancing. And before, he used to be like, yes, and he does it everywhere. And I used to be like, no, stop, you're embarrassing us.
Yeah.
But he was embarrassing us, he was embarrassing me. And so I got used to it. And now I just let him do his thing wherever he's at. And if I can dance with him, I will too. Because that's just his thing. That's his happy place.
Do you guys ever meet other people like you on the road? I mean,
We do. We met some cool RVers in Venice Beach in California because they banished all of the RVs. So like this one commercial row because I guess there were like issues or whatever. So that's like kind of a cool thing. It's almost like an RV park, but it's not. It's right in the middle of Venice. So we met some cool people there. And other than that, that's really it. Like we're pretty antisocial.
Really?
We come on our RV, we'll do our pop up, do our little shopping.
And we give it all when we come out. Like when we come out for a pop up, I mean, we sometimes end up talking to people for hours afterwards. It's like when we come out to give our energy, that's our time to do that. But then we need to retreat. So.
Now, do you find people are very receptive on the road to what you guys are doing?
We get so many love notes in our box. Like, not only do people give us money, but they give us notes letting us know you saved my life. Like, I come here on my lunch break and I'm grateful to see you guys playing and just Wow. The love is amazing.
And that's why we
see people crying. They have to walk away crying.
Yeah. And that's why we kind of try to just pop up where we feel we're needed. Like this one spot that now has become like a live music spot in downtown Phoenix. Never had live music before. It was a lunchtime area, just a bunch of restaurants where people, everybody that works in the office buildings downtown comes.
Yeah. Right.
And so we came and actually the day Trump got elected, we did our first pop-up there and we had like so many notes of people telling us like, thank you, like you saved my life. Like I didn't know what I was gonna do today, but you guys just like changed my whole view on everything. Yeah. So ever since then, we're like, okay, we gotta stop trying to do like what buskers are supposed to do and just continue being purple people and go where we know we're needed. Yeah.
Mm. So being that with the tight bond you guys have, and I know you guys have different personalities, how do you guys lean on each other? Like who has what strengths, who has...
She's a firecracker, and I'm
a Leo, and she's a Cancer. Yeah. So I'm the sun, and she's the moon.
Yeah, fire sign.
That's
a good balance.
No, because when I need to, hold on, she needs me to, no, don't let them, and it's like, oh, yeah, you're right. I do have rights. I'm too nice.
You are an empath. You are a purple person to the core, and you understand your responsibility for other people's lives more than your own.
Literally, come up and be trying to fight me. I'd be like, "Oh, you need a hug? Come here."
That's why you were a nurse.
Let's just hug, right? Hug, talk it out. Yeah. So that's...
And you're the total opposite.
Yeah. Well, not the opposite. I am very chill, but I also I have certain things that aren't gonna be allowed, and once you cross that line, it's over. It's over.
I love it. Yeah. Well, these ladies are very talented as well. So you are watching the Empower Hour. Hanif and I do this program every Wednesday from 2 to 3 p.m. And you're going to get a taste of how talented these ladies are. They're going to get set up while I go into the promotions for the program. They'll get set up and they're going to give us a taste of what they do on the road. So again, we're at Everlasting Life, which is located at 9185 Central Avenue in Capitol Heights, Maryland. Everlasting Life is a vegan restaurant, but with so much more to offer the community. There is a lounge, full-fledged lounge with a stage. So we do host different events on an ongoing basis. And if you're looking to rent a facility for parties or things of that nature, Everlasting Life is open and available for that as well. The other two locations is Vigorito's and Evolve Restaurant and Lounge, and they both are located in the Tacoma Park section of Washington, D.C. But back here at Everlasting Life, each and every Thursday from 6 to 8 p.m. is our children's night. Children eat free, 12 and under, so bring them on out. They have a good time, they eat some healthy food, and they play with other children. So that's each and every Thursday evening. Following that up on Fridays is our dinner and a movie from 7 to 9 p.m. We air a different movie, and then we discuss what we've watched as a group. So come on out for that. That's always free every Friday from 7 to 9 p.m. Black Wall Street Renaissance, which is coming up this Saturday, every first Saturday of the month, we host a shopping bazaar. So other vendors that come out and we fill the room, and you come and you shop and you help circulate the dollar within your own community. And that takes place every first Saturday from 12 to 6 p.m. Marketplace, we do host another shopping bazaar that takes place on the third Saturday of every month from 11 to 4 p.m. where you can come and shop for fresh produce and natural supplements, organic herbs and spices, vegan groceries. So it's an all natural herbal spin on shopping, and that takes place again every third Saturday of the month. Elife Studios right here. If you're interested in what Hanif and I do on a weekly basis and you have a voice out there and you want to get it out to a larger audience, consider joining us here at Elife Studios. We are looking to host other people in front of as well as behind the camera. And you can find information online at elifestudios.com. Okay, back at you with the Empower Hour. Nick and Six is going to bless us.
Yes.
With with some of their own music.
Yes.
So I'm just gonna. Can you see them?
Here goes my answer.
Wow. Okay. I'm ready for some more.
I know.
I mean, if you, as if there's time.
Yeah, okay.
One more.
Yeah. What are you guys doing? The practice. When you guys were practicing here.
Oh.
Yeah. Shade.
You guys
want to
do that one?
Sure.
Okay. Yeah,
you
before
the ready.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Oh, no, we were just sound checking.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Audience members, and if you guys, can we take a poll?
No, we don't.
have any questions.
Okay. So, wow.
Good stuff. Thank you for blessing us.
Thank you for having us.
Feel the energy in the studio already.
Yeah. Awesome. Yeah. That's good stuff.
Yes. Good stuff. That's the room where you can ship the
camera. Yeah. If you don't mind, let's go here. Yeah. So some of the music was original.
Yes.
So who writes?
We both do, yeah. But those two originals in particular, or the one original we did, was from my EP that I self wrote and produced, and it's called I Am Organic. And I actually released it the day Making Six formed as a band.
Oh, okay. Now, excuse my ignorance. What's the EP?
It's like a short album. Really, honestly, it started off, it was supposed to be like a 3-track EP, but I just had so much on my mind that it ended up being 7 songs. Okay. So technically it's an album, but I didn't intend for it to be that, so I still call it an EP.
So where can the people get your music?
Nickandsix.live.
Yes. Okay.
Nickandsix.live.
You go to the website and
you can see our blogs. We got a sounds tab with music.
Yeah.
You guys do vlogs?
We've
been documenting our journey, basically. I don't even want to call it a vlog anymore, because now it's become so much more than that. But it's been dope getting to, because we got to basically tour for a year without a camera, without documenting anything, and so now it's been this year of it.
Trying to capture as much moments as like that one Tracy Chapman song we played. We met the drummer that was on that song. We were out busking. We stopped him in his tracks from the intro. He turned around and
he recognized the song.
It's just like, whoa, like amazing things like that happen on the street. So we want to capture that. We want to start.
What's that?
Nickandsix.live.
Yeah,
Nickandsix.live.
And that's an N.
Nick, N, the N. Six. Only because online you can't put an N symbol, so.
Okay.
When people asked us what our hashtag was the first time, we were like, Nickandsix.
No YouTube.
Everything is linked in through Nickandsix.live. Our vlog is technically on YouTube, but I don't even know what to tell you to search there. Our website is our social media.
Where do you guys, with everything that you're doing with the this is called Purple Days?
Purple Days movement.
Where would you guys like to see that go?
Our next stop is Europe.
Yes.
But after that, we would love to see Purple Days take over Tokyo.
I want to get global, but I also, I mean, stateside, since we're from here, I do want to get a plot of land where I can have the Purple Days Festival. We've been going around trying to meet other artists to have the ultimate collab, the ultimate Purple Days. So
because honestly, we were both ready to retire when we met each other.
Yeah.
Us
from the music?
Nickandsix being an act under Purple Days kind of just happened because honestly, where we were, there was nobody that was good that we felt like, okay, we can develop into a genuine Purple Days caliber artist. So we're like, Nickandsix to me should set the standard. So we're boots on the ground, learning where our artists will and won't be able to go in terms of doing pop-ups and
DC just recently
possibly banning Amplified Busking. And we already have a little band, a little boy band that we're developing, and we wanted to bring them here, but now that might
that's
not
what I was
going to
say. So you guys have other artists that do the pop-ups as well?
Not yet. Any artists that pop up. We have people that we're working with and interested in working with. We have not taken on anybody as a full-time Purple Days artist to develop and actually be able to do their own pop-up music festivals.
That's a lot, because there's so much happening all the time. You have to be able to focus on what you're doing. Because you got sirens going by, you got folks coming up yelling in your face, you got people trying to throw trash in your thing, it's just so much going on.
It's something about our energy makes people sometimes lose like their impulse control. So like we've seen like people like literally come by like screaming and hollering, like,
oh my god,
yeah, just right, like in our ear, like, or right in our face of our camera. Yeah.
So just because we've been working professionally for so many years, I feel like we've been prepared for it. But when we do actually take on artists, like that's gonna be a thing. Like
you're gonna have to have a boot camp.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Like, you don't know how many times a mosquito has been on my arm mid song, but it's like, if I stop, what am I gonna happen?
Yeah, music if we stop.
Stuff we never think about.
I know.
Sitting there enjoying.
Right. My glasses are falling. I meant to put contacts on when I wear. You know, they slide in. And I try to not miss a beat, but you know.
I've seen you guys perform in Silver Spring before, downtown Spring, and it was mesmerizing. So I was like, you know what? I'm about to get my lunch and camp out right here. Watch these sisters.
Yeah, downtown Silver Spring is such a
It really is. I was with my son that day, and we just sat under the shade and just listened to you guys.
And the way they have the buildings mapped out that way, it just echoes so beautifully.
So what are some of the your favorite places you've been?
Together?
Yeah.
Grand Canyon was really dope. We actually played in the Grand Canyon, like unplugged, us billowing out into the Grand Canyon.
What was that like?
That was amazing.
It was powerful.
It was so powerful.
Yeah, it was powerful.
Wow.
Yeah. I was like shaking.
Imagine.
We also, a lot of our dopest things happened in this recent cross country trip. We actually also were on Black Wall Street on the 97th anniversary.
We happened across the country, and that was
amazing.
That was
we actually got to take a nap on the grounds, like where the bombing happened.
We laid right on the grass, had lunch, and just.
Did they do anything?
They had pride that day. We're not even gonna get into it. That's why we are just like F all labels except being a purple person, because why are we not celebrating our ancestors that were here today as opposed to
like
celebrating?
And they put a new plaque on the wall, but it didn't look like anybody
even
honored that day, even on the anniversary.
The fact that pride was that day, that should tell you enough. That was, they are not trying to talk about what
happened.
They have the memorial there, but on the anniversary, they're having pride there.
And then I don't think all the businesses that are on the block are even black owned.
None of them are, from what we saw.
This is weird. Like,
is it a lot of black people live in the area, live in that community?
They built up a college campus on where like Black Wall Street was. Because it was over 2,000 businesses, so it's like a whole stretch of Tulsa that's like now a college campus.
Yeah.
And so the two of you guys, you guys are sisters. He has a black woman. So when you guys are out there and having this life, living this lifestyle, there's not a lot of sisters living the way you guys are.
Yeah.
So I'm assuming the crowd that you tend to run into, is there like a lot of stereotypes maybe that are projected, like, or shocked? Many people are shocked, like,
we
like,
get so like many different responses.
Maryland Mansion night?
I mean, because we we literally one night were outside of a Marilyn Manson show, like, I had my head wrapped just like this, like, and we're out there playing Creep and Radiohead,
and the white guys are trying to tell us, you know,
this is the Marilyn Manson show, right?
So
we used to like his music too. We're all just childish for still being into it, but
But people think we're only supposed to cater to a certain audience. We play outside of any venue. I don't care.
I mean, people come up and call us like India, India, let me hear something. I'm like, who are you talking
to? Like, we're our own people.
Yeah.
So you guys don't try not to get caught up in the labels and
Yeah, no, I don't identify by anything except African human being.
I love it.
Have you guys traveled outside the country already?
Yeah.
We have, just not together.
Since joining forces, but not as a band.
This fall we'll be headed to Europe, so can take our pop-up.
How long do you guys plan to be there?
We don't plan and we don't abide by time, so
yeah.
We literally don't abide by time. Where we feel we're needed.
And we'll go and we'll hang out for however long we want.
Are you guys usually on the same page with that? Where like maybe someone says, you know, I feel like we should be doing this, and someone was like, yeah, me too.
Yeah. You?
Yeah. Like, yeah. Yeah. It's creepy how in each other's heads yeah. we are. Like, it's okay. So, I'm like, did I say it aloud? Like, did you hear me? But
okay.
We're in each other's heads. So wow. ridiculous. It's
yeah.
awesome, though.
Yeah,
the,
yeah.
I mean, we don't have any beats. We're able to live in this small space. Like,
yeah. I mean, to be living in a yeah. tiny home together for going on 2 years now. I didn't even realize it's been 2 years.
Yeah,
so.
Yeah, but you wouldn't know it because we can step outside and there's parks, there's, you know.
Right.
I know we gotta wrap up,
I
want each of you guys, because you guys are artists, clearly, mm-hmm. but tell me something about yourselves that people would never guess.
Well, I know something about myself that people would never guess.
What's that?
That even though I worked professionally as a performer from the age of 2 years old on for, like I said, 20 plus years now, my business manager slash grandmother actually literally stole every single dime I ever made. So that's another reason that
that's
we
a fun
are
fact
on
fact.
Tour. That is a fun
that
fact.
That is a fun fact.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, yeah, like, yeah. I was on Broadway. I was on tour.
She's
got
Michael Jackson, all that. Yeah.
I was on Law and Order SVU. I've been in multiple commercials. Like, been working since being that age. And my grandmother stole every single dime I ever made.
You've been there. That's a fun fact.
Okay.
Yeah.
Why would you say?
I don't know. I feel like I'm pretty much open.
Okay.
People know about me. I don't know. I tell every area. I'm 36. I'm from the suburbs of Henrietta, New York.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Are you introverted?
I am, but then I'm not. Like, I'm shy. I get nervous when it's a lot of people, but then I've gotten out of it. Like, I used to play with my hair in my face when I first started
what?
My first band, and I'll just peek out, like, no, you can't see me, and then something happened, and it's just like, oh.
This is a good balance. Definitely.
Would you consider yourselves free?
Yes. Absolutely.
Wow, they have tattoos.
I'm free.
Yeah, I'm free.
Oh, so the watch, the song is
yeah, no time.
Watch.
Free.
Yeah,
free.
Love it.
Yeah.
Oh, guys, it's so unique.
I know.
Oh, but I look forward to just bumping up against you guys one of these days on travel somewhere on the other side of the world.
Yeah.
So,
if people have a function and they want you guys to perform, like,
you guys make that live. There's a contact tab right on there.
We'll do weddings.
We did a wedding in St. Thomas last summer.
That's where I'm from.
We enjoyed ourselves.
Yeah, it was beautiful. We camped out right on the beach. And
really?
Yeah, it was awesome.
Yeah, we got eight of them.
Y'all was on that beach at the dark. That's
yeah,
what happened.
Well, I admire both of you.
Yes, I do.
Thank you.
So thank you for sharing your stories, and I'm hoping that it will inspire a lot more people. You have inspired me.
Yes.
If anybody wants to get into the tiny living, I'll help you convert a van, a bus, or whatever. Like, I love doing that.
This one here.
I'm telling you. I'm obsessed.
Awesome. I can do it. I love cutting, sawing, painting, building. Like,
I wish you guys' vehicle was here. I would have loved to see it.
I know, me too.
Next time. We're definitely going to bring the RV by here because we literally come here to eat all the time.
I've seen you guys in here before, and then I also saw you Silver Spring, but I see you come in here and eat together.
So we'll definitely be there guided to let you guys see the RV and everything.
If they come by and I'm not here, call me. You guys have to come back on the show when you're in town. Thank you so much. Thank you. We appreciate you guys. Again, that is our Empower Hour. And Hanifa and I will see you again next week. I hope you enjoyed the show. Take care.
Peace.
Peace.
That was dope.
And the voice of the youth. Love it. Did she chat with you guys a lot?
Not these days.
Last summer she used to come to our pop-ups.
She was our little mascot.
Now she's in tennis camp.
Okay, family. Thanks for tuning in. Share the information. Take care. Peace.